Hello everyone, welcome to EduTap. So today we have in this success story session Mr. Atul, and he will be telling about his a long journey he had in different examinations, and he has cleared RBI grade B in 2020-21, and so he will be telling about his journey. First of all, hello Mr. Atul.
Hello ma'am.
Congratulations, heartiest congratulations for clearing like RBI grade B.
Thank you.
He had already cleared SBI PO and SSC CGL, and he was working in the CAG department, and still he gave the RBI and he cleared the RBI while working. So it was a great achievement, I can say.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, so he will be telling about his education qualification and the journey that he had, a long journey, I can say. From 2013, he started for preparation, and like 2015, we can say he started his preparation and he gave various exams. He has a rich experience of various exams. So like, over to you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. I have done my BTech in mechanical engineering and I graduated in there 2013. Okay. And I have actually placed from my campus placement only. Thereafter, yes. I worked for around 2 years in LG Electronics India in a commercial AC division. It was a core mechanical job. Back in the year 2015, June, I took a drop and I started preparing for the UPSC exam. And I was not able to clear the prelims in the 2015, but in the year 2016, I cleared the prelims, but could not clear the mains. In the 2016 itself, I gave the exam of SBI Probationary Officer and I was able to clear it in the first go. And thereafter, I joined State Bank of India as a Probationary Officer in November 2016. From there till July 2020, over around 3 years and 10 months, I worked in State Bank of India and I resigned from the banking services in the July 2020. Thereafter, I joined CAG and as a assistant audit officer, and I'm currently working with the CAG from the past 1 year.
So you said that from 2017, you were trying for RBI grade
yes.
B. And after, like,
yes, after joining State Bank of India, I was able to, you get a familiar persons who were preparing for the exam. From there, I came to know about the RBI exam, that there is one bank which is better than the State Bank of India. So from there, I started preparing for the Reserve Bank of India.
And he has already given like three attempts in which he was able to clear phase one. And in the last attempt, that is 2020-21, he was able to clear the RBI grade B and he became the officer.
Yes, ma'am.
So that was a really nice and long journey. And yes. What kept you motivated? Like, you had already cleared like SBI PO and after that you cleared the like SSC CGL. Still, yes. Your motivation was there. You wanted to get RBI.
At the time I joined State Bank of India, so we form a group. So from there, I have a friend who cleared the Reserve Bank of India exam back in the year 2016 only. He was a good friend of mine. And when you are constantly in touch with some person who is working with the Reserve Bank of India, so you come to know about the opportunities there, the kind of lifestyle they are providing, the kind of facilities they are providing. So from there, I came to know that this is a better thing than State Bank of India, what I'm currently having. So from there, I maybe started paying for RBI. If you have to be working in the banking sector, then it should be RBI only.
Yes, that's really good. So your motivation was that you wanted to have that thing that your friend had. You wanted to live that kind of life where you
can
kept
say
you
that.
Motivated.
If you are working in the banking sector and you want to have a career in the banking sector, then and that too is the government bank, then you should definitely opt for RBI.
Okay. So, and you came to know about RBI from like when you were doing SBI PO,
yes,
that job.
That job.
Okay. So, and you are a mechanical engineer.
I'm a mechanical engineer.
Yeah. Okay. So now we will start with the strategy portion. So
yes.
In phase one, like you are a mechanical engineer. So there will be many questions like how you did GE and all, but we will start from QRE. Logical reasoning.
Being a mechanical engineer, I am from my past experience for preparing the UPSC exam, I have no such issues in preparing the aptitude part. Let me tell you a story about my SBI PO examination. If people know that in the year 2016 itself, SBI changed the pattern of the examination from what they were doing in the past. For the same line of pattern questions are there. In the year 2016, they changed the pattern completely. So being a mechanical engineer and I was preparing for the UPSC, I have not such background of preparing this aptitude questions. But you are not able to solve the question in a quick manner.
Yes.
Like people are doing in just seconds. So I was not a person like that. I know the basics. I can solve the question in a basic manner only. But in the year 2016, when SBI changed the pattern and they shifted to some hard questions, the aptitude question English part. So that was a boon for me. I wasn't preparing for that. But basics I know. So I cleared the SBI PO exam with the flying colors. And thereafter, if you see in the year 2017, 2018, the RBI aptitude exam was also on a different side. The other difficult side only. if you see the cutoff of the pre and the exams, each time it was only 70 marks or 80 marks. So from aptitude side, I don't need any kind of preparation. That was there for me always.
So you didn't even try for mock test or you
no,
gave?
Nothing okay, like
so
that.
You were confident. Aptitude,
yeah, I was confident that in aptitude, if paper are like this, difficulty level will be high, I will be clearing it with flying colors. Only portion that was needed in the current affairs, GFAs.
Yes.
Because the type of question they are asking in the PE exams, they are only, you can say, one word questions are there. If you know the answer, then you will be able to do it. Otherwise, not. So my main focus was on GE only. That I have to score around 50 marks out of 80 if I have to clear the PE cutoffs in a comfortable way.
Yes. So, yeah, from like coming from a mechanical engineering background,
yes,
you must have like a good quant and reasoning. Like
quant and reasoning, English, those were good.
Yes. But like GA portion is the thing that engineers are like, they do not focus on that because that's not a part of their work.
Yes, you can say that. And so, what I was preparing at the time, that was the UPSC exam. So yes, the type of questions asked in the banking sector about the GA section, those are completely different from what I was preparing. So
yes,
I just had to go through some kind of apps, some kind of quizzes questions are there, and I have to revise all of them.
Okay. So yeah, there is a misconception that the UPSC background people are like more like, it is a boon for them because they are doing the GA portion. So did you feel that?
Phase one, I can say they are, it is a boon for them. Okay. Because for phase, if you see in the past also UPSC aspirants, they do a protest to remove the portion of the CSET. It means they are not comfortable with the aptitude portion.
Yeah.
So aptitude phase one is common for all. If you have a good aptitude, and even if you are preparing for the UPSC exam, then you need some kind of different strategy covering the GA part. For phase one, we need a different strategy. I can say UPSC aspirants are not getting any kind of undue advantage in phase one. Advantage can be there in phase two, but I won't say in phase one.
Okay, in phase one?
Phase one, everybody's same.
Okay, so phase one, the pressure shouldn't feel like the UPSC background people have some like benefit. It is like same for all because the portion is like different. The GA portion is different for even the UPSC background people.
Yes, they have to prepare the GA part in a different way, but they are preparing for the UPSC exams. There's a one-word substitution like who is getting this award, who are the obituaries. So these type of questions are never asked in the UPSC examinations. So if you are preparing for RPA exam, you need a different kind of strategy to cover the GA portion, even if you are a UPSC aspirant.
Okay. So like, and how, what do you feel that there should be an integrated preparation for phase one, like GA and phase two ESI, or like for GA, you should do it alone? There should
definitely be an integrated preparation. Each time whenever you're reading a newspaper, say in newspaper, there is some kind of article is there, which is related to World Bank or some IAF. There is some kind of policy change. So if you are reading that portion at the time, just make a quick note. Because if these type of questions will not come in in the first phase, then they are definitely going to be asked in the second phase.
Okay.
So if you are covering GA on a daily basis, then you should definitely prepare for phase one and phase two at the same time. You cannot cover phase one at one time, and there is only a gap of 15 days in phase one and phase two. So you don't have any time after phase one to prepare for the phase two especially.
Okay. So, and how did you revise? Because like GA is like so many names, so many areas and all.
Note making, ma'am. You can say note making was always a boon for me from the college time.
Okay.
So if I am reading anything, then I'm going to make a note for that. Because note, you can say revision is the key in cracking any of the examinations. If you have notes, I don't know how vast the syllabus is, but if you have make notes and notes are crisp and precise, then you can revise it in, you can say 1 day, 2 day, 3 day. So note making is the key. But if in covering the GA portion, especially for phase two, whenever I'm reading any kind of news, and I think that this news is important from any point related to economy, related to banking, I will definitely want to make note.
Okay, so you focused on note making.
Yes.
So,
In phase two, I can say note making was the key from my side, clearing the phase two examination.
Okay, in phase two, you made the note, like you focused on note making. And phase one, like right now, like if we talk about the GA.
Yes, revise some quick facts. Like if the content is low, for example, there are many kind of awards, but there are few awards which only few people get.
Yes.
I can say if there is an award for Padma Shri and Padma Vibhushan, so you will see definitely see that Padma Shri award there are many more, but Padma Vibhushan award there are very less.
Yes.
So focus on that Padma Vibhushan award only. There are only 6 or 7 recipients will be there. So in same way, if some big personality has died, there are n number of obituaries every year, but you're going to ask which is currently in the news. Some kind of political conglomerate is there, and some kind of star is there. You can say some kind of superperson is there. So only quick on the basic facts. Rest you will do if you do the quizzes from n number of institutes are providing quizzes on a daily basis. Just do those quizzes. Stick to one source only. Complete it fully and then revise it from n number of quizzes provided by many different institutes.
Okay. So, like, can you tell some of your sources that you followed so that the aspirants get an idea?
I followed an n number of sources. My main source for covering the GK was GK Today. I can say GK Today was the main source. So, and this Indian Express newspaper. Thereafter, I supplement the same thing from the quizzes. Like, there are few apps like GK Today also has a quiz app. Then Bankers Adda has a quiz app. There are 10 to 15 questions on a daily basis. Then you will see Vision IAS monthly affair notes are there, which will help you in the phase 2 and phase 1 also. So this time from there, I supplement my preparation. Okay. Main source was GK Today and Indian Affairs, the Indian Express newspaper, and I supplemented from a number of sources. Okay. Where I am getting short quizzes.
Okay. So like newspaper is also very big now. So how did you cover the news? Like, what was your strategy of covering the news?
In case of RBI, I would say aspirant has to stick to one thing only. That is, RBI is not an exam. You can say they are not asking for a specialization of economics or statistics. Yes. So if we stick to this, then we have to stick the main topics. Like, there is some kind of guidelines issued by the bank. Like, there is a news related to insolvency and bankruptcy code. And if IMF is saying something to RBI, to change their policy, like there for World Bank, it can also be there. If government is changing some policy which is affecting the economy, so you have to stick to those questions only for the mains part. For the pre part, you can have n number of sources. Whatever they're in sports, whatever they're in news, it will be there.
Okay, so you should focus on the syllabus only.
Syllabus
like
only.
In the GA also, if like the award is coming, so you should study like what from the exam point of view.
Exam point of view.
Yeah, you shouldn't study like whole paper, any accident or anything happening.
Anything related to Bollywood, nothing. Nothing is required. Yeah,
because it will be a waste of time and the time is like very less for the preparation usually. Okay, so for phase one, I think we have covered everything. For quantum reasoning, you said like you were like comfortable and you didn't even need to give mock and everything.
One more thing. In case of phase one quantitative, I would say to the aspirants, if they should definitely know the how to basic steps of solving any questions. But from past experience, what I have seen in the RBI phase one examinations in 2017 and 18, the paper was tough. The paper was on a tougher side. If people have their basics cleared, even if they don't know the short text, they will be able to sail it. But in the 2019, the quant reasoning part was on a lighter side. So if for those guys who were not able to solve the questions in a quick manner, I think they won't be able to clear the PA at the time. So people should prepare on both parts. But they should know the basics, how to solve it. And for some of the questions, they should know the tricks. So more questions in that limited period of time available by that.
Yeah. So your concepts should be clear. Yeah, you can apply your tricks or the basic method if your concepts are clear.
Paper is on a lighter side, paper is on tougher side. Quant should be there. Quant should be your strength area. GA portion, I don't think, except few people who will score more than 60. Most of the people score around 45 or 50 marks. Yes, please go ahead.
But there are some people that are very afraid of quant and reasoning. Means not reasoning maybe, but quant. People think, yeah, we won't be able to do it. Some like message for them.
Ma'am, I would say in any kind of examinations, you clear examination always on your strength side, not on the weakness side. If you have, if some portion of yours is weak, then either make it strong or make other areas strong.
That's a very good message. Yeah. If you are like weaker on quant, you must be stronger on GA or some other portion.
Definitely, ma'am.
Yeah.
So if you are weak on the quant side, then score around 70 marks in GK. Make it strong.
Yes. Yes. Okay, nice. For GA, you will like read newspapers and different websites, give different mock tests for the revision purpose. So that will be strong if you give like, if you keep on revising through the mock test also.
Mock test on a daily basis. They are providing quizzes around 5 or 10 minutes. 10 to 15 questions are there. Whatever you have learned, whatever you have read in the whole day, just revise in the evening.
Yeah,
and this, it is not required that you do it on a daily basis. Even if the say the prelims exams in is 30 or 40 days away, then start doing it before 1 month. No need to do it. And I would say you start doing it from 3 or 4 months back before the examinations.
Okay. For journal awareness, how many months will you prefer?
That's a tricky question. You should cover 3 months exhaustively. And if we have covered the last 3 months, then you should go for 6 months. I don't think more than 6 months is required to cover the GA portion.
So now I think we can move forward to phase two. And yes, for phase two, there are three sections. So yes. What was your strategy for English? Like you started from essay, pressy, or reading comprehension?
I would definitely say again, this paper two, this is essay writing. That is also my strength part. In the year 2017, I scored around 85. In the end 2018, I scored around 84, 83. So paper two, before what I was preparing before appearing in this examination, that is UPSC, the essay writing and precis was on a comfortable side. But if you know about the topic, my only strategy was to cover the topic. If anything is all, I should know about it. Writing was never an issue, neither in the precis, neither in the essay, and neither in the paragraph also.
Okay, so that's nice. For ESI, again, like ESI in mechanical engineering and ESI is something like that doesn't go hand in hand.
Definitely, ma'am. And whatever RBI was asking in the past, in the year 2017-18, they were going with you will see this comprehension questions were there. And based on each comprehension, they were asking 4 or 5 questions. So if you haven't covered this comprehension part in newspapers, you won't be able to solve it. Yeah. In the year 2017-18, I missed the, I think, mains cut off around 2.5 marks, 1.75 marks. This was the marks ratio because of which I wasn't able to clear the mains. So what I changed this time was only this Indian Express newspaper. I have to read the article. So whenever some questions come on based on comprehensions, I should be able to do it. If I have read it here, then I read somewhere, I would definitely do it in the exams. This was only strategy.
Yeah, and schemes are a very important part of ESI.
You have rightly said, in the year 2017-18, if you have seen the mains questions, then scheme was a major weightage was there to the schemes. But in the year 2021, schemes was not having the major weightage because of change in the pattern of the examinations. So what was there in the past that was not applicable in the 2021? So okay. RBI is changing it very dynamically. So what I would suggest to the aspirants, if whenever RBI gives the notifications, definitely go with the syllabus in exhaustive way. What they are, how the pattern has changed, what they are giving there, then prepare their strategy based on the syllabus, what they ask.
But what were your sources for scheme and reports and everything?
For schemes, what I did in 2017-18, I go to each of the websites, major departments of the Government of India, women and family health and family welfare, then home ministry is there, ministry of rural development is there. Go to the website, what are the schemes that are the major schemes run by the Government of India, make a note, each and every major scheme that is available on the website. I did not opt for any other sources, any other coaching materials, whatever they are giving. Go to the basic source, what they are provided on the website only. Website only cover the schemes, not write it down. And for each year, if you have made your notes one time, each year you have to supplement only the figures, what is the budget given to that scheme. The rest things will be there only. There is no change in eligibility. There is no change in coverage. Most of the things remain same, only the budget changes every year. So just, I would say, go harder or make effort on the first time. Then in next years, you only need to update the figures only.
And now coming to the FM part, finance and management.
I would say Munan Patel is the main savior in finance and management. I have done my economics and every static part that was available that is required for the clearing examination, I have covered from Munan. Munan videos are there, and then there is a book Sanjeev Verma. There is a weakness from my side. If any book having more than 300 or 400 pages, I'm not definitely going to do it. I cannot do it. Seeing the pages, if the book has more than 300 pages, I can never finish the book. So Sanjeev Verma was the book for the economics static portion. Only around, I would say, 180 pages are there. So I was able to cover that book in a very stupid or even a short period of time. And that book really helped me. So covering the static part. Inequality? What is economy? What is inflation? Those standard topics based on which some questions is asked in the examinations.
And how did you the pattern changed in this year, 2020-21?
Change of pattern was a boon for me. As I already said, in 2017-18, I was missing the mains cutoff by around 2.5 marks, 1.75 marks. And each time, ESI was the main culprit. I wasn't able to score good in ESI. I was scoring around 58 marks, 60 marks in ESI. The rest two portions were good, but the ESI was a big, I was doing blunder in the ESI. This year, pattern changes. Now there is only 50 marks for this current topic, and 50 marks will be the subjective. The subjective portion, if you see on an overall note, then around 200 marks are from the subjective side. you can say, but I used to tell my friends that this year the exam is only for me. So I have left my job last year, and the RBI has changed the pattern, examination pattern this year, and they have gone to the subjective part. And subjective part, touchwood, was my strength from the my past preparation also. So I was very hopeful that if subjective portion is there, so maybe I have to just give some more extra efforts, but I will do great in subjective part.
Okay,
so change of pattern was very beneficial for me this time.
Yes. So can you tell the aspirants that what structuring should they do, what structure they should use for the descriptive?
I would say, ma'am, there is an interview I watched, Gaurav Agrawal, who was a USC topper, UPSC topper in the 2012. Yes. So he used to say one thing about essay writing or any type of answer writing, ki make your answer so simple that it is not very difficult for the evaluator. What is the message you want to convey? The more simpler you write, the more marks you are going to get. If you use any kind of hard languages, any kind of hard vocabulary, which even the evaluator is not able to understand, then how is he going to give you marks?
Yeah, that's nice. Because most of the people have the misconception that they should use hard words, like heavy vocab, then they will get more marks. But
ma'am, yeah. If I am the evaluator, if you are using some kind of vocabulary, and I don't know the meaning. Maybe one time I will check the meaning of the vocabulary in my, you can say, any kind of dictionary. But if you are using that vocabulary again and again, I will get pissed. Okay, yes. What he is writing, and I'm not going to give you marks.
Yes.
To make the you can say, job of the evaluator easy.
Yes.
Your message should be clear. It's not like you are writing in layman language. But you can say the evaluator just wants in kind of any kind of essay writing. What a layman should know if there is something which is happening. Now you can say if there is some news about the healthcare, so what government is trying to do, what are the schemes, only what you can say layman people, the normal people should know, you have to write that much only.
Very, very good message for the aspirants that you should write what the people, what the evaluator can understand.
If I am only going 4 or 5 points and you are also writing those 4 or 5 points only, I'm going to definitely give to you good marks.
Yes.
What I know you have written there. So I will give you the definitely very good marks. He knows what I know. So I am going to give 50. I will say I will give 45 in essay writing. So these type of things are there. Make your answer simple. Make the job of the evaluator simple. It should not be tough. Otherwise, the evaluator will not give you good marks.
So, and like you prefer writing in points or in paragraphs or in...
Paragraphs only. I'm simple. Whatever is the topic, then first define the topic. What topic wants to say. Then what are the, we could say, define what government is doing. Definitely, if topic is related to something, you can say on a dynamic side, government has launched some kind of scheme, some kind of message is there. Definitely a simple starting, what is the definition, then the main body, then the conclusion, what is your stand, what should be done. In 3 or 4 paragraphs, it will be good.
Okay, nice. So now we can move forward to the interview part. So how was the interview for you? Was it grilling or the panel was cordial?
Panel was cordial. And I would say interviews, again, I can say my strength side. Based on the experience, I can say RBI has declared the marks. I scored 59 marks in interview.
Yeah.
So being 59 marks, I think it is, you can say not the highest, but it will be one of the highest. But there are people who score more than 60, but I think 59 is also very good marks in interview.
Yes, absolutely.
As I have already said, I have more than 6.5 years of working experience. So what's my strategy in clearing the interview? I was sure that based on my profile, that I have worked around 4 years in State Bank of India, and I was doing in branch operations only. Then definitely there are going to be some questions from SBI. Then there are definitely going to be some questions from my current organization. That is CAG. And that is, you can definitely know there's a constitutional body and doing the audits. And audit is also a part of the RBI. RBI doesn't do audit, they do inspection, but it is somehow related to them. So what was my strategy? That I am having experience more than 6.5 years, then I should focus more on my experience because they are definitely going to put questions.
Yes.
So, and then definitely going to put some based on my experience. Then you pose some questions to yourself based on your personality. Because one of my friends used to say that interview is not a test of knowledge. They have already tested your knowledge. You should know something. It's not like you are blank in the interview panel, but what they are trying to measure is your personality. How you are responding to their questions. Is there anything you don't know? If you don't know something, then how you are responding to that? So these types of qualities are measured in interview. Knowledge is not their main factor. You should know. It's not that you are blank, but how you are responding, what is your body language? These are the main criteria they are judging on.
Okay. Yes, the personality plays a major part in an interview.
Definitely, ma'am. Like I would say, some of the questions they asked me, I was preparing with one of my colleagues that if they ask me about what should be one quality that should be there in any kind of RBI employee, then she suggested that you should go with the integrity. That integrity is your main strength. Then there was a question, I said, what are the moral values? What are the ethical values? What are the legal values? So I was discussing these kind of things with my colleague. And she helped me a lot, what you should say. And in the at the time of interview, they asked me a questions. And I would say around 8 or 10 questions were thrown to me. And majorly questions were those for which I was already prepared. But then those were the questions I already prepared with my colleagues, with my friends. And this is what they suggested me, I told them, as I was already prepared with those questions.
Okay. So it is not only important to take like mock tests for phase one or phase two, you should also be prepared for the interview. Like you
Definitely,
should do
ma'am.
The mock interviews.
If RBI is giving 75 are the total marks of interview. And
yes.
I would say if you are scoring 59, 60 marks, more than 60 marks, even if you are having less marks in the phase two examination, then also you are, there are chances are more if you score good in your interview phase.
Yes.
There are friends of mine who have scored around 195 in mains, but because of the interview, they are not in the finalist because it's poor marks in.
Yes. Okay. So it was really nice. And is there any,
one more thing. I have worked with State Bank of India in the past. So if there was a question that I was saying, what question they will ask if I say I was working with the State Bank of India. So my friend said, first question, how would you define the customer service of State Bank of India? Because people always make a mock of State Bank of India because of the customer service. And the same question was asked to me in the interview. And they asked me simple questions like, what are the three best things about SBI? And you won't believe what was the answer. First thing I was saying that the customer service is the best thing about SBI. So the panel was shocked how you can say that customer service is the best thing about SBI. But I was prepared for that. Okay, I would say that customer service is the best thing. But then say your second thing that people mock about SBI is they follow very rules and regulations. Even if आप कभी भी जाएंगे वो आपको मना कर देंगे, ऐसे नहीं होता. तो ये एक कस्टमर के साइड पे एक नेगेटिव पॉइंट है. बट दिस दैट वाज माय सेकंड पॉइंट, व्हाट इज द बिगेस्ट थिंग अबाउट एसबीआई, रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस. तो वट एवर यू कैन से कस्टमर इज हैविंग अ नेगेटिव इंपैक्ट अबाउट एसबीआई, दोज वर द पॉइंट्स व्हाट आई टोल्ड द पैनल, दोज द वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग पॉइंट ऑफ एसबीआई. तो बेस्ड ऑन एक्सपीरियंस, इवन इफ सम काइंड ऑफ नेगेटिव इमेज इज देयर अबाउट योर पास्ट एम्प्लॉयर, then you should correct those images in the mind of the interviewer.
Yeah, that's a really good message from you, or we can see a learning from you, that you should not only see the negative side, you should take out some positive thing also from that side. So that's a great learning. Still, there is any message that you want to give the aspirants, the freshers, I can say?
I would definitely say, please bear one thing in mind. But like I said in the beginning of the interview, any exam can be cleared only based on your strengths. If you know your strengths, then definitely work on those strengths. If you have some weak part, just try to make it strong enough that you clear the threshold for that particular part only. But exam can be cleared only on your strengths. If you you invest most of your time on your weaknesses and you know that cannot be improved up to that level, then I don't think you are having good chance in clearing the examinations.
Yes.
Focus on your strength only.
Okay. And there are many people that have been preparing for 2-3 years and they feel like, yeah, they can't clear it. So they're kind of demotivated. But you prepared for so long. You have been preparing from 2015 and still you were motivated. Even after getting a government job, still you were motivated. So any message for the people that feel demotivated now?
I would definitely say change your route, you can say circle.
Okay.
If you are having a circle where everybody is failing, okay, then I think definitely you should include some people who has already achieved something.
Yes.
If you change your group, I want to say change your group, include someone who has already cleared the exams, because he can give some positive vibes to you.
Yes.
Okay, what are that one? If suppose, like I said, the people are preparing for more than 2-3 years. So if they feel demotivated that now they should give up their examination phase, then they should definitely ask to someone who is already working with the RBI. Because what he will give, that what are the benefits, what are the good things about RBI, those things will motivate you. If you stick to your circle where everybody is thinking about giving up, then how will you become motivated?
really good learning that yeah, like changing your environment also benefits.
Changing environment also that.
Yes. So you can change your environment. You can again push yourself that you have improved so much. So you can still improve and you can still do better in the next Definitely. Exam. So that's a really good learning. And I think now we can stop it. Really, thank you so much, sir, for attending the interview and for coming and talking with us. And we learned a lot of things. I learned a lot of things. So I hope the aspirants would have also learned a lot of things. The patience and the calmness that like resonates from you. So that was a great interview, sir.
Thank you, Kriti.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.